Okay, so we're talking about all these skill transfer movements, and we just talked about a little muscle up, we talked a little bit about handstand push-up, and we see that everything is same. Handstand push-up, the skill really is this micro skill that you see, because you see all these other pieces moving. So we see this and we think, oh, it's hip flexion, extension, and knees and all these things. No. What we're doing is we're going from a globally flexed position, which was this, into a globally extended body position. And this is where people get caught up. They get caught up in the shapes. If you come over here to the board, I can maybe show you a little better. When I am at the bottom of my handstand push-up and I have that little tripod going on, I kind of look like this. This is my head. My body kind of goes like that. My hands, let's see if I can even draw this, go like this. And then my butt is somewhere here. And then I have my knees and my feet. People look at, oh, the elbow, the knee, the hip. That's what's bent. No, I look at this, this line. That's the midline. If I can see that and understand that, I know that I'm globally flexed. I'm not worrying about the local. I don't care about that. I just care about global flexion. This is when we talk about skill. When I come out of here and I kick out, my hands stay in the same place and my body ends up here. Head neutral, hips neutral, toes kind of pointed. This is what I'm looking at, this line. So I went from global flexion to global extension. That's my kick out. If I can understand that from a skill perspective, I will add a lot of value. And what I'll do is I'll simplify how everything works. And that way I can give my athletes ways of coaching themselves. So that's key. And then the strength is more this. What is the complexity of it? Oh yeah, the shoulder, the elbow, the hip, the knee, the ankle. That's what's working. But I need to start looking at the progression from a skill perspective, from a global perspective. If I can do that, I am golden. So let's take this to one last thing I just want to show you on the burpee, which I think is extremely important, and it's part of our jumping and landing. When we talk about burpees, just in general, we just say, hey, get down to the ground and back up. So if you look at that, get down to the ground is me flexing. I hit the bottom, I'm in a neutral position, and then I come out, I extend, flex, extend. So it's an extremely complex movement pattern. I go from flexion to extension to neutral, to extension to flexion to neutral. It's hard, and it goes back and forth and has so many moving pieces. That's why the burpee is so hard. But why is that not possible to coach? Well, yes, it is possible to coach, and we coach it all day. But there's a problem. All our athletes, when they just start in a freestyle position, whatever, neutral, as they bend over, their body has developed bad movement patterns and behavior. So when they get over, they're here. Oh, I'm here. I have to get out of it. Oh, I just did 100. My shoulder's blown out. My knees feel funky. My hips are broken. Ankles are broken. That doesn't work. So I need to treat my athletes like they're 5-year-olds. So I'm going to say, hey, I'm gonna tie your feet together and I'm gonna keep your arms really close to your body. If I do that, what happens is as I bend over, my body immediately goes into this good position of knee out, toes down, heel down. That position is key because that happens to be my squatting position. If I am here, we know that's poor. So feet together always takes you out, knees out, better position, except for people that have a little ankle problem, that have flat feet, sometimes they feel more comfortable caving in, or they're hypermobile, or they're overextended here and they're living in this bad position. Those are the people that are gonna cave in. So if you're that person that bends over and the knees don't come out, check your ankle, check your back, are you broken? Are you a little tight in the front? Or are you hypermobile? So those are things to think about. Now, this is the big, big one. When I come out of the burpee, this is not a strict push-up. And we did this position video where I did this strict push-up into a nice burpee. But that's not how you're gonna do 1,000. That's not how you're gonna do 2,000. What you need to do is you need to add skill. Skill is gonna carry your performance, your strength. So you're allowed to bow and snake this thing. key thing is that when I snake this thing, I do not stay soft in the back and the butt. My butt is on, chest comes up. Now from here, I'm peak loaded. I can snap my feet in. That snap happens to be the same thing we see on kipping pull-ups, muscle-ups, and even rope climb. And it's the same everywhere. But it's key that the butt is on, the belly is on, and I brace against that, And I use that loading and unloading to give me skill. And that's my burpee. Can I bend over, come down, chest comes up, snap, feet come in. This is 90% of artistic gymnastics, being able to bow back and forth, snap down, turn things around fast. And it happens to be Olympic weightlifting. I go from extension to flexion, stand up to neutral. And if I understand that, then I see skill transfer in everything. And that's what's gonna carry. So now, that being the burpee, and we just demystify that butt out is bad, butt on is good, and that bowing is okay. This is actually skill. This is how I do 1,000. This is how I catch up with the best in the world, right? So let's move on, let's take this to the rope and see if we can see the same shapes. So we're on the rope here, and I'm not gonna give you all the details on rope climbing, but I wanna show you something. And if you saw Annie Thorey's daughter climb the rope at the CrossFit Games 2011, she had this very unusual way of climbing rope, which is not very unusual if you watch any kind of circus performance. That's how it goes. What she was doing is she was saving all her strength for the higher volume clean and jerk that got heavier and heavier. And a lot of people said, hey, are you really gonna take the risk and link the clean and jerks? Sure, she's not gonna use any grip strength on the rope. And how she's gonna do it is she's gonna allow skill to carry her. So if I take this wrap, which we've called before the Spanish wrap, and I have it hooked, what I can do is I go from this position where you can see that I'm globally flexed, and I don't know if you can follow me here, but what I'm doing here is I'm just extending the body, which happens to look like my drill that I did for the rings. This was my muscle up prep. So I go hip up, hip to the rope. No arm pull. If I pull the arms, I just broke the skill. That's like pulling early in Olympic weightlifting. So I want to go hip up, now arms follow, reach. If I understand that, I can wave myself up and save my arms. I don't want to use my arms. I want my arms to just be my directors. So I'm here, big hip. I can let go of two hands, reach. I kick up again, go into that flexion. So this is global flexion, extension, reach. The cool thing about this is that you will arch me from the side. This looks exactly like my muscle up transition. The only thing is that I don't finish all the way. So one more time, kick and wrap. I go hip up, muscle up transition. If I shoot my head through past the rope, I get that transition, I can let go of both hands. Hips, let go of both hands, reach. Kick out, hips, let go of both hands, reach. Being able to let go of the rope is telling me that I'm fully hooked in and that I'm using and maximizing skill. I need you guys to start seeing skill on the rings, skill on burpees, skill on handstand pushups, skill on rope climb, it's the same. So everything is same. And how do you take this and you apply it to Olympic weightlifting? If you can't do that, something's wrong with the program. That's what we're trying to demystify right here. So rope climbing, however you do it, can you add high level skill? This doesn't work with every rep, but the principle stays there. And it's balancing strength and skill that gives you some sort of outcome. I call that freestyle. And those are the different shapes. And that's what you label as kipping pull-up, butterfly pull-up, frog pull-up, whatever that is.